So I managed to get the first part of this playthrough through the copywriting bullshit. There's a high potion. I had to edit it 4 different ways and upload it 4 times for it to happen. The first 3 times I removed the areas that got flagged, shortened them a little bit, got rid of what was directly on screen at that moment, and still got flagged again. The final one that actually made it past was just with the complete intro removed. So this is the ones that can put you to sleep. That thing puts you to sleep, all of you, and then that thing just bangs on you. And so does he. I think he can confuse you, the Gandarewa. I could be wrong. But I don't know if we're going enough to kill it, and I don't want to risk attacking it just in case. There you go. Because I don't think if you hit it with magic, it procs its counter response. One. Look at Auron's life. That shit's beastly. Getting them cheers on. This has to be Blizzard. Overkill. So Overkill does one of 2 things, I believe. It increases the chance of them dropping their rare item, and it gives you more experience. It multiplies the experience that you receive. So overkilling is really important. Oh, you bastard! Oh, it's only thunder. I always found it funny that his groin wears the same mask as his face. It's like his penis is just as important. So the question here is there any chance that he could hit that flying imp? And I don't think he can, so we'll try. This guy doesn't like water. I don't know why my nose is running, it's so frustrating. It's not ran for like 3 days and now all of a sudden it's just like, yep, let's start running. Let's do this shit. What did you say? Well, we took fire. 700 last time. I'll just have to be extra diligent at removing them. I know I've let one go at some point, like a sneeze or a cough or something that was really loud. And then when I was editing back through the material and scrubbing it, I just couldn't find it. I knew it was there somewhere, but I had 17 individual 30-minute videos to scrub through, so it would have taken me all night. So unfortunately, your viewing pleasure will suffer from a sneeze or a cough at some point. But such is live playthroughs, warts and all. Actually a whacker. Let's drop you out. Let's power break this guy. But I was trying to play the online mode for a game called Sunset Overdrive the other day. And the online mode is called Chaos Mode, where you and up to eight people get to do silly things inside the Sunset place. City Sunset or whatever it's called. And I couldn't find a game. And that game's not that old, so you'd think that there'd at least be hopefully a pretty dedicated market of people playing it. But I managed to get into one game and it was okay, I guess. It was a bit crazy. I don't think it's very balanced. When there's 8 of you, you were just shit stomping everything. And you can't play it on your own, which is annoying. But yeah, I was matchmaking, looking for a game for about 15 minutes, running around the city collecting stuff. And lo and behold, he's gonna kill Lulu if I don't kill him. Yeah, he's gonna kill Lulu. Oh, we're okay. I think it would have been his physical that would have killed her, if anything else. But I wasn't even doing anything too intensive, and it was nighttime, so the peak moment on my internet wasn't met. So there's no reason for me not to be able to find a game, other than there's nobody playing it. Which is pretty sad for people who pick up that game and want to play online. I know my friend wants to, so hopefully he had more luck than I did when I tried it. I remember dying on this place in the Mushroom Rock area, and I've not saved for a very long time. And RPGs do that thing where they just revert you immediately back to your previous save. And I've never liked that. You know, I always thought it was really punishing, but it's kind of just how they always were. Should probably be using these overdrive, but at this moment in time I seem to just have it queued up. But I've been watching a lot of AGDQ. And if you've never watched that, you really should. It's a pretty damn fun stream that's been going on for the last few days, and it's going to go on for another two, where people speedrun games for charity. Always makes me want to speedrun something, and then I realise that my attention span's too short. But it's cool watching them break stuff. Like doing out-of-bounds tricks on Arkham City that involved going into cover and throwing the batarang, which I had no idea that shit worked. Should have probably chucked her out for Wacka so I could blind it so we didn't take any damage, but hopefully it'll miss. Just wish we'd have won that Blitzball tournament. I could have geared the strength spheres to Auron and hopefully beat some stuff up a little bit more effectively. Put a confidence in our stride. But we're getting strength spheres, so that's okay. Our power spheres. Not that we're going to need them. When we get to the Calm Lands, you can always fight in the arena and get stacks if you overkill things. Uh-oh. I missed. He's gonna go do it again. That's very rare, that. Just missed my mouth with my coffee. Like a civilized human being. That is not rare. That happens quite a lot. Ah, you bastard. If I tell a lie, his mask on his groin is a little different to the one that he's rocking below. Titus is looking fucked. Bye. Interesting, all three of those two are both weak to Blizzard. I knew you'd do that. Never mind. Wacka must have higher accuracy than Titus. I suppose it makes sense with him throwing a giant ball.
We've been expecting you.
Okay. Doesn't give me any items, thank you. Thanks a bunch, woman. You're arseless chaps. Here we go. Chain of magic. Assholes. Oh, dude. So, 63 on a physical, on a weaker physical, 76. There's just no point unless you've got mad stats doing that against these. But that's where magic comes in. Lulu can be incredibly effective when you get her on the MP count as 1 and stuff like double cast. Yeah, she can be incredibly devastating. Is that
in the end,
Shalinda again?
I wasn't able to stop them. But seeing their fierce determination, so I decided.
Okay, well. It's like having a conversation with someone without wanting them to participate. So you're kind of using them as a wall to bounce off of. Kind of, you've got a thing against Tidus. Oh, goodness me. Good job, Lulu. That was a real shit show just then. Wow. Dumb asshole. Ooh, interesting. Did we guard that? That was really strange. Bum, bada, bum. Oh, whoa! I just got like a mad push. That was awesome. Will that work? Oh, he's got such shit magic. Funny though. I did quite enjoy it. That, my folks, is why you don't have Tidus casting. Unless you've got the stats for it. It never ends well.
The presence of a maester, myself in.
Yes, that was awesome. Now stop shoving your chocobo's ass in my face, please. Thank you. Obtained a high potion. I think we're on Dark Aeons here. I can't remember. I want to say they're the Major Sisters, but in truth, I don't know. Excuse me. See ya. Ooh, no. For ya. Oomph. He landed as if. A damn Imperia, or whatever it's called. Impy Bastard's what I call it.
Lady Summoner.
Oma. The magical water rock. The erection from the earth itself. What you got for me, Chief? X potions, very nice. Something on this corner? No. Safe spot coming up though, so we'll definitely be using that. Another Garuda, eh? E. Oh, that's unfortunate. Just cheer that shit up, son. Very good, Wacker. Very good, sir. That one looked impressive. I feel like it should hit harder, that move. Even though it's just his standard attack, it's not like we did anything special or anything. /215. Still blind, but blindness has just run off. What is this doing? Aside from mild death, like us all. Sonic Boom. Yeah, I expect as much. And then they should probably kill him.
Farewell.
Yeah, it's. I hate it when it syncs up like that, where you're just under what needs to do to kill them. Ooh, Bright Shield. Is that the one I bought, by any chance? To add insult to injury? It is not. It stops me from being blind. I don't know which one of these takes me. Oh, it takes me down, so this is hopefully going to get us something interesting. Oh, yeah. What is it? Serene Armlet. Is that encounter half or something? Who has armlets? Why is everything for Kimari? God damn it. Kimari, stop getting all the gear, dude. This is a dangerous one. How did your fat ass get the first turn, dude? I'm calling bullshit on that. Getting the first turn. Maybe this guy's not weak to anything. Can I do all by pressing? No, I can't. That was a weird one, that when they introduced the concept of hitting all targets by modifying it with like an R or an L button. Because on 7, wasn't it, you had to have the materia joined with all materia for it to hit everybody and have it linked. It's a pretty contrived way of doing it, but that was pretty early on. In the PlayStation era of Final Fantasy anyway. Which is what I count this as. Solo. Does the Power Break do anything more to you than standard hits? More than 300? This guy's got a ton of life. I wish you gave a little bit more than what you get for killing him. Why are there 20 feet? No, Lulu, we'll not have you attacking him like some common peasant. Oh! And he dies. He doesn't die. We did less damage this time. Ooh, crit, nice. Sonic Boom. It must have been Wacka there. Unless. Or maybe we're just not on the right rotation. Ooh, nice! Could have done with the crit earlier, Auron, but I'll take it. We should get something more. Let's check it. Guaranteed level. Mana spheres, power spheres, and a bright bangle. And I think the bright bangle is for Lulu. Something's gonna blind us, it must do. We keep getting a lot of anti-blinding shit. So there's something down here. As you can see by the windy map. Albed Primus, son! Have that language translated in no time. Oh, come on, Garuda, fuck off, dude! Hey, my team is... Yeah. Let's do this. It's kind of funny how these animations now look like what the PlayStation 1 does, because technology's advanced so much. When I first saw these, I was absolutely astounded by them.
Help us?
No, he's gonna pick his ass. How's he gonna help us? Oh, it weren't even enough to kill the fucking thing. Does that heal him? That's pretty funny. I could keep those two guys alive and have three heals while I kill him. Which is probably what I should do. Unless they put me to sleep, because that could be bad. But then he'd wake me up. Pretty funny. I love his little bouncing attack. Ooh, interesting. There's a status effect on that attack. I reckon the Garuda probably blinds you. Trying to slip you in the tongue. Like an over-eager mother-in-law. Oh, two attacks. Shit. I have no idea what his overdrive will do, so I'm just going to land an attack and then I'll do it next. Introduce these little bastards to the concept of hellfire. Once they've quite finished. I love the overkill of this. It's like, okay, that's two attacks. Oh, and we'll just heave up this huge chunk of earth and throw it at them. And it's somehow a catalyst for this great explosion. Pretty cool. I do like the motion blur on the screen when we do that move. This motherfucker hurts, man. What? I forget you get mad recovery after doing those moves. Look at the when you do that, the recovery difference on the attack. Yeah, this guy's got quite a lot of life. Oh, Oh, a little trick as well if you don't know. Cast their element on themselves. Free heal. Sometimes it's a waste of time though, because they can out damage the ability that you have. But we got what I wanted anyway. Got to see some Ifrit. I could have just done his attack, but I'll save it for a rainy day. I don't know if that translates to Yuna's. So what we'll do, bring our friend Wacker in, blind him. And we'll take Yuna out for Auron, and we'll bang on him.
As you wish.
Interesting. I wonder if he's weak to ice or if he just keeps getting lucky crits. Bye. So, because we were in a bit of a shitstorm, then I'm going to use a high potion on Lulu and Tidus. And hopefully we don't have to fight too much when we get to that safe point. Careful. 400 gil, eh? Not too shabby. So I can't remember if the save points rejuvenate you or not. It's been... I've not been paying attention. I have no idea how the algorithm works for the footsteps either. To kind of avoid combat if you can even do that. Look at that motherfucker. Why, dude? Like, I literally have no one else to hurt you, so I suppose it's the most intelligent move you could have done. And now she's gonna get it with this and he's gonna shit on her again. Because that's how this bullshit works. She hit Auron, or he hit Auron, whatever the fuck that monster is. It. But her power comes at a price, as you see. She's got very small HP. So ideally, you want to send her on a magic slash HP run on her sphere grid, but sometimes it's not that easy. I want to be careful talking to people here, because I might trigger something I don't want. Did that heal everyone? Well, it looks like it did. Oh, I just did what I didn't want to do.
Why only you, sir? I want to fight too.
Orders are orders.
I'm not a cadet anymore, sir.
How big is his head?
Let me go with you and I'll prove it to them.
Guarding the command center is important too, you know.
Look at my octagonal sleeves.
I came all the way from Besaid to fight Sin, sir.
I know, but an order's an order. To your post, Crusader.
But, sir!
What if anybody catches cold in spirit? Because everybody seems to have rather revealing outfits.